greetings and thank you for taking just a little bit of time, perhaps, to think about something that might be important and be helpful in the week that's ahead of us. Yes, it is the Memorial Day in the United States, and it is a holiday, so most people aren't working. But I remember many, many years ago when I was going through a broadcasting school, we were taught that if we wanted to be good, if we really wanted to be world class, and that's what the school was all about, they were making sure, and they made sure that every graduate was very good, or they didn't let them graduate, because that's how the world worked for that particular school called Brown Institute in Minneapolis. And I'm a proud graduate, and it took a lot of work to graduate and accomplish that. But I remember we got a message from Mr. Brown one time we were coming up to a holiday, and it probably could have been Memorial Day, and we wondered whether there was going to be any class on that day. And the director said, because this is a school, you will be given the day off. However, you need to know. And then he looked right at me, because he knew he would look at me and the rest of the people would get the message, because I was the oldest in the cohort there. And he said, I remember, Mr. Hustad, and the rest of you, that if you succeed in the radio business, you will never have to celebrate or get to celebrate a holiday again. And what does that mean? Then he went on to say, the radio station is on every day of the year. And if it just so happens that it's on every day of the year, that means when it's Christmas or 4th of July or any other holiday, the radio station is on. And if you are scheduled to work on that particular day of the week, whatever it falls on, you're on. You're going to be there. So unless it happens to fall on your regular day off, you're going to be behind the microphone and you'll be doing radio. And you know what? That was really true for me. And there were many holidays, Christmases or 4th of July's or something very similar, because we were oftentimes overseas during that time. And the national holidays of particularly Holland and parts of Latin America, everybody took the holiday off, but not us. We were on the radio and we had to go to work, and we had to do it with a smile and enjoy it. Sometimes we got a little extra treat from the boss because we put in some extra time on the holiday, because oftentimes they did try and let people who were not vital to the production have that day off, which meant that then we would actually do extra work as well as our regular broadcast shift. Well, I don't have to do that much anymore, but I'm always reminded that, this is Monday, it's Memorial Day, but I'm supposed to be at work. And so I'm going to take just a few minutes, because something significant happened, and I really had some very strong feelings about something that happened, and I thought I would share them with you, and they're certainly relevant to Memorial Day. And that's going to lead me to the topic that you saw, which is, on this Memorial Day, you should be grateful to be alive. That's the program. And it begins right now. I hope more and more that is my attitude toward life. One of the things I learned in some of the worlds that I worked in, for instance, particularly in the Caribbean, we discovered that one of the favorite songs of many of the people was One Day at a Time. And sometimes I got a little tired of playing that song, but you know, then I began to realize that the audience that we were working with, many of them were poor folks and struggling folks, and that was their motto, One Day at a Time. We're lucky to be alive and have something to eat and maybe some work, maybe something to do, one day at a time. And so that has more and more become, I think, a part of who I am, particularly as I get older. I'm more and more grateful for the opportunities, you know. You get up in the morning and you celebrate the fact that you got up. You are grateful for every day. And an attitude of gratitude is very important. As I often say in my performance coaching, that, you know, hey, a thankful and grateful heart. A thankful and grateful heart is seldom a fearful heart. So every day spend time being thankful. Say thank you at least 100 times. Try to cultivate, and it is one of my 5 favorite words. Remember that from a lesson a few weeks ago? Grateful. Wonderful word. I am grateful. Well, here's what happened yesterday, Sunday afternoon, after we returned from church. It was raining out and pouring out, so we didn't have a chance to go out and enjoy the sunshine in the nice Sunday holiday, because there was no sunshine in a nice Sunday holiday. It was cold and rainy. And that's not the way it should be here in North Carolina on the Memorial Day holiday. So we stayed home and we put on the Netflix, and all of a sudden we saw a film come up, and just as it came up, it was talking about World War II in Holland, which meant that caught my attention right away, because we lived in the Netherlands for 5 years and had a wonderful time there, but we became very, very familiar with Dutch history, and of course, very, very much the fact that during World War II, the Dutch were conquered and occupied by the Germans, and that was a brutal regime in there, and thousands of Dutchmen were killed and executed in that thing. And so that just happened to catch our attention. So even though we didn't know anything about the film, and it was called The Forgotten Battle. The Forgotten Battle. Now, some of you may have heard about it, but, you know, I'm not much of a movie freak, so I really hadn't. But we said, okay, let's watch this for a while. And we noted that it was put out primarily by some of the Dutch nonprofit organizations trying to preserve some of the history. And it turns out, as it says, that it was based on a real live event. Well, it was pretty graphic, very much like, remember some of you, the film Saving Private Ryan, the violence, the war scenes, the bloodshed, the dying, the screaming, all that went into those war scenes, that was very much duplicated in The Forgotten Battle. And what it was is there was a battle that was hardly recognized that took place in September of 1944, just as in June the Allied forces had landed in France and Normandy, and they're on their way up France through the Netherlands, through Belgium, on their way to Germany to try and put an end to the war. And this little area called Zeeland, which is way down, kind of to the small part, least populated, most western part of Holland. And the reason it's mostly hardly populated, and the Dutch provinces are very heavily populated, is a lot of this is just islands and water. A lot of it's below sea level, as is much of the Netherlands. And it's dikes and bridges and things like that, and small islands that keep things together. There was a very significant battle that took place, and it was a ghastly battle. And this story centered around the people who, some of them were collaborationists who tried to get along with the Germans. Some were committed to the Germans' National Socialist Nazi vision, but many of them were just trying to get along. so that they wouldn't die. And then there was, of course, as there always was in all of the countries that were occupied by the Germans, there was a resistance movement. Underground people who were trying to sabotage and work their ways to help the Allied victory. And so all of that took place, and you have to understand the story by just simply saying this. It was a story of duplicity, of terror, of torture, of bravery, of great courage, as this particularly one family struggles to make it work. And in the end, part of the end of the story, but it wasn't the full ending, the 17-year-old boy who was working with the resistance is captured and tortured, and eventually he gives up the names of his colleagues. The Germans arrest them. His family, who had been working with the Germans, but only because he was a doctor and he worked with anybody who needed help, begged to please, please go easy on him. Well, they tortured him, got more names, and they broke their word. And they sentenced the young 17-year-old boy and five of his collaborators. They took him out, wrapped around a post, and a huge firing squad shot him. And that was part of the story. But what really got me as I watched these scenes was just the fact, you know, here I am. You know, you're a man in my 70s, doing well, and it just struck me as I saw the battle of these men dying. You know, men in their 20s, in their 30s, maybe a little bit older, in their teens, dying, and having their bodies blown up. And I just couldn't help but think, my goodness, I didn't have to go through that. Not at all. And here I am. And I think particularly, not only did you see the younger people, like the Dutch boy, but also at that time, the Germans were taking anybody. And a number of the German soldiers, of course, not all of them, but a number of them also were just young boys. 15, 16, 17. And in one particular scene, there's the battle scene, and the bombs are exploding, and there is this, obviously, a 16, 15-year-old boy who has his German outfit on, sitting there, and the terror, the fear and the terror in his face was well portrayed, but deeply moving and compelling. And you know what? There were a lot of young German boys that went through that. And a lot of them died by the hundreds, by the thousands. And I can still see that picture in my face. And all those men and all those young boys had a life to live and a future they perhaps thought about and girls they wanted to marry and have children and have good jobs and make lots of money. Everything that a young man or boy talks about it, thinks about at those ages and stages. But here they are fighting in a war that is taking their lives, ruining everything for them, and there it was. And the story did not show it, but probably in one of the explosions, it implied that the little 16-year-old that I was so moved by the picture probably was killed. But whether that was true or not in that particular case, it was true thousands of times in the last days of the German army, in which everybody was thrown into the war. By the way, so were many American people. One of the friends of our family, a cousin of my father, was a simple farmer, and toward the end of the war, the draft said we have to have a lot more, so he lost his farming deferment, got put into the army, thrown into Europe. He obviously went through basic, but he wasn't trained. He was basically a clerk. But in the last months of the war, everybody was given a rifle, and off they went. And in just April of 1945, the war ended in May, he was shot and killed. And we knew his wife, an aunt, and a cousin of ours. All of that happened. And here I am, and there you are. And guess what? You know, on this Memorial Day, it's probably good for us to be very, very grateful for those who obviously gave and sacrificed so much. But you know what? I think we need to also remember to be grateful for the fact that here we are today, alive, grateful to be alive. And I hope you are too. That's the deal for the day. I'm Stan Hustad. These are interesting ideas. We've got a lot to talk about this week. We're going to be on Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays for now on for a while. The 3 days of interesting ideas. More and more, I have to help more and more people like you become radio broadcasters. So not only is this podcast being done, I have a number of others for people like you who are discovering, just as I have, that if you want to reach and connect with your audience, and if you want in some way to bring your message and your story to life, and perhaps have a touch of immortality, and maybe make some money, you need to learn how to be a broadcaster, a world-class podcaster, and that's what we can help you do. So reach out to me at stanhustad@gmail.com, stanhustad@gmail.com. And thank you, Lord God, that people died for our freedom, and in some gracious, graceful way, we are grateful. Today, we are alive and even well, and some of us are even doing well. My goodness. We truly have much to be thankful for on this Memorial Day. Best and blessings to you. Till next time on the radio, I'm Stan Hustad for Interesting Ideas. Bye for now.